Christianity is a blasphemous religion made up of liars and hypocrites. You say that you follow the Messiah, yet you follow the doctrines and traditions of men that came from your father Satan. YEHWEH Elohiym made his son to be in the image of his word in the flesh by giving him his seven spirits without measure. This is not the image of the Messiah that Christianity follows. You follow after lies and you lie to yourself to say that you follow the Son of the Most High. In following after the make-believe images of him that you have chosen to believe into, you bathe in make-believe blood. You're a bunch of hypocrites and you are a brood of vipers with no shame for offering your children up to the lake of fire like you have done for generation after generation. At best, some of you buy into the false traditions of Judaism in order to make yourselves feel more religious or more righteous. One of these false traditions is Satan's counterfeit of the Sabbath being on Saturday. Saturday worship is no less of an abomination than Sunday worship is. Our Creator does not use Satan's pagan Roman calendar to reckon the days. He uses the luminaries just like his servant Moses recorded. But you have had no fear of going against him, so you have not considered whether or not these false traditions are what his word testifies to. Your traditions and your feast are an abomination and a stench to him. You have chosen to believe into Satan's lies so that you could live in rebellion to our Creator. In order to do this, you had to reject the writings of the prophets that he sent to you. He sent his son to bear witness to these writings, yet you rejected them anyway. And in rejecting these writings, you have rejected the pathway that explains why he gave his life. Living his word teaches us to become as he is, but you have believed into other images of him to worship instead so that you do not have to become as he is. This is no different than what the children of Israel did with Baal back then. Your G guy that you worship is Baal, no different. And the J guy whom you call the Messiah is the son of Baal. He is a make-believe Messiah. Some of you rebuke me in your make-believe J guy's name. I laugh at your rebuke because I laugh at the make-believe image of him that you worship. I certainly have no fear of your rebuke because I believe into the true image of YEHWEH Elohim's son, which is his father's word. Following the true image is walking on the same pathway that he walked on, which is his father's word. I have no fear of any other image of the Messiah that is different than the image of YEHWEH Elohim's word, so rebuke me all you want. His word testifies to his righteous character and his righteous image that his son became. Most of you laugh or you scoff at his righteousness. You scoff at stoning the unrepentant adulterer and let adultery flourish in your midst, causing hurt to others and causing fatherless children and such another hurt. You not only do not agree with stoning the false shepherds who teach rebellion to YEHWEH's pathway, you embrace them and you love to listen to their lies. His word testifies that you're a bunch of whores to him for worshiping your make-believe images of him and his son. His son magnified his Torah and said that there is no other way to eternal life. I have been sent to you bearing his word, and nearly all of you have scoffed and mocked, and many of you have even laughed outwardly at my face. You truly have no shame for your nakedness. You have no fear. You cannot even see your hypocrisy for saying that you believe his word when your very lives testify that you do not believe it whatsoever. His word that you claim that you believe gives irrefutable proof that he has sent me, but his word means nothing to you because it has no place in your rebellious hearts. By not believing that he has sent me, you prove that you do not believe it. You're not believing what his word says testifies against you, that you believe in your hearts that it is a lie. No, you are the liars and the hypocrites. His word is truth. His son said so. If you believed his word, you would know why he is sending a double portion of his wrath to the scattered nations of Israel, and you would turn from the reason why he is sending it and be not partakers of his wrath. He is sending it because of rebellion to his word. If you believed his word, you would know that you are the scattered nations of Israel, because his word testifies to who they would be in the last days. And I've spoke about this in other videos. The prophecies have unfolded the way that they have to prove that the United States is the great city that is like Sodom and Egypt. They prove that the prophecies for Jerusalem in the last days represent the United States, because this is the head of where the scattered nations of Israel are scattered and where they reside today. Like I said before, primarily the English-speaking nations. The U.S. represents the captivity of Babylon to a T. And she is going to fall, and great will be her fall, because she is built on the sand. She is not built on the rock, which is YEHWEH Elohim's word, the word that his son became. And the same thing goes with her blasphemous religion that over 80% of her inhabitants are drunk off of. The arrogancy and the hypocrisy of America's founding fathers to say they base this country on the principles from YEHWEH Elohim's word is incredible. The reason why this country was blessed is like it was is because of the birthright promises passed down from Abraham's seed. And these blessings are part of the witness against you, because you have trampled these blessings underfoot by trampling the Most High Son's blood underfoot and doing so with no shame. You are drunk off of the wine made with sour grapes, and you sleep in your father Satan's bed. The wine that caused your fornication is the make-believe blood of your make-believe Messiah. And now dying you will die if you do not turn from your abomination and hearken to YEHWEH Elohim, who created us to become as he is, and agree to the terms of why he created us, and seek to become why he created us. He allowed for you to choose to go your own way, because he was building his temple from your midst during this time. So his son and rain came on the just and the unjust. His temple was built with his word. It was what all were measured with, the 144,000 who became his temple. And now his temple is finished, and he is going to purge out all of you who refuse the terms of the renewed covenant that he is offering to you through his son's real blood. The 96.6667% of you who refuse the conditions to the covenant that his son brought will be purged from before his face. You will be judged by the word that you have rejected. And he's sending his son with his word coming out of his mouth like a sword to judge you. The conditions are genuine repentance. Genuine repentance is agreeing to follow his son with the intent to become as he is. And it is leaving your lives for his kingdom's sake. It is leaving everything that is false that came from the father of lies. If you claim that you are following his son, but you are not living by the Torah of Moses with the statutes and judgments, you are a liar and a hypocrite, and the truth is not in you. His son is his word, which includes the Torah. And his Torah is not the traditions of the lying, hypocritical rabbis that are in Judaism who have perverted it like they have. If you enter into the renewed covenant on YEHWEH Elohim's terms, he will give you his seven spirits to write his Torah in your hearts and in your inward parts, and they will guide you into all truth. He will turn the water that you need to be baptized under into his son's blood, and he will remove your transgressions as far as the east is from the west, make you white as snow before his eyes. But sadly, only 3.33% of you will make this choice, because you really are that stubborn and rebellious, and you really are in love with your make-believe Messiah and his make-believe blood and your make-believe versions of his father. You love your father Satan instead, and in his more excellent way that he sent through liars like Saul of Tarsus. You really hate our Creator's righteousness that his word testifies to. And you're a bunch of liars and hypocrites to say that you believe his word, because you do not. If you did, you would hearken to it. You trumped the writings of his servants, the prophets, and his own son's words with the abomination of desolation, Saul of Tarsus' writings instead, so that you could justify your rebellion to our Creator. And now that his temple is built, you will be recompensed for your rebellion to him if you do not turn from it. Thus saith YEHWEH Elohim.